All right, friends, here is chapter 2 of Wayside School Beneath the Cloud of Doom. It is called A Million. By the time Terrence got to school, he had already kicked 99 different things. It started the moment he woke up. He kicked his bed. He kicked Rocky, his favorite stuffed animal. When he left his bedroom, he kicked the door shut. He kicked the wall as he sat at the kitchen counter and ate cereal. He kicked a table. He kicked 3 chairs. He kicked rocks on the way to school. He kicked the flagpole. Still, as much as Terrence liked to kick things, it would take him his whole life to kick a million things. "How much is a million?" Mrs. Jules asked her class.
Oh, I know, said Mac, stretching his hand high.
Mrs. Jules called on Mac.
"A million," Mac answered proudly.
"Well, yes, I suppose that's correct," said Mrs. Jules. "A million is a million. Anyone else? John?" John lowered his hand.
999,999, he paused, and then added, plus one, he smiled.
"Ooh, that's good, John," said Dana, very impressed.
"John's really smart," Joe agreed.
Terrence wasn't paying attention. His big toe hurt from all that kicking. His toenail was too long. Shari, who had been sleeping at her desk, suddenly awoke and said, 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10. She rested her head on her red and blue overcoat and went back to sleep.
"Is that right, Mrs. Jules?" asked Jason.
Said Mrs. Jules as she tried to multiply all of Shari's tens.
"Well, if Shari said it, it must be right."
"Arithmetic makes my brain numb," said Damien.
"That's why they're called numbers," said DJ. Terrence's big toe throbbed in pain. He couldn't think about anything else.
"There's really one way to understand just how big a million is," said Mrs. Jules, "and it's not by using arithmetic. We need to collect a million somethings."
"Dollars!" exclaimed Joy. Everyone cheered. They liked that idea.
"Then we could have the biggest party ever," said Dee Dee.
"We're not collecting $1 million," said Mrs. Jules. "Any other ideas?"
"Pumpkins," suggested Dana.
Everyone cheered Dana's idea too, but not as loudly as Joy's.
"I don't think a million pumpkins would fit in the school," said Mrs. Jules. "We need something small and not too expensive."
Stephen suggested, "Little pieces of paper."
Nobody cheered.
"Boring," sang Kathy.
Stephen felt hurt, but deep down he had to admit that collecting bits of paper wouldn't have been a whole lot of fun. Ron suggested mud, but that too was rejected.
"It's a good idea, Ron," said Mrs. Jules, "but you can't count mud."
"Why not?" he asked.
"There's no such thing as one mud or two muds," explained Mrs. Jules.
"Why not?" Ron asked again.
"I don't know," Mrs. Jules had to admit.
Terrence couldn't take it any longer. He took off his shoe, then his sock. One desk over, Rondi stared at him, horrified. Terrence's toenail was bent out of shape and it had turned black and blue. He opened his desk and took out his pair of safety scissors. Then, crossing one leg over the other, he started snipping.
"You can't cut your toenails in class," said Rondi. "It's against the rules."
"Who says?" said Terrence. It was one tough toenail, and the scissors weren't all that sharp.
"Mrs. Jules," called Rondi. "Terrence is cutting his toenails right in class."
Some kids laughed. Some kids said, "Gross!" Terrence pushed hard on the scissors. At last, a piece of his toenail fell free. His toe instantly felt better.
"Terrence, come up here now," demanded Mrs. Jules, "and bring your toenail with you."
Terrence picked up the clipping off the floor. One shoe off, one shoe on, he hobbled to the front of the room.
"Give me that," Mrs. Jules demanded.
Terrence dropped the nail clipping into his teacher's outstretched hand.
"You're a genius, Terrence," said Mrs. Jules.
She held out his nail clipping high in the air. "That's one," she announced.
999,999 to go!
All right, friends, I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll read another one next week. Bye.